It's Friday, February 22nd here in Seoul. Welcome to Korea's Daily News from Korea Now. I'm Debbie Won. We're now just 5 days away from the second U.S.-North Korea summit set to take place in Hanoi, Vietnam on February 27th and 28th. And today we're going to take a closer look at the details leading up to what will be another historic meeting between U.S. President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. Now, as the two countries are engaged in negotiations for next week's summit, a senior U.S. official told reporters on Thursday that the United States is seeking to move quickly and with very big bites to denuclearize North Korea and offer a brighter future for its people. The negotiations are being led by U.S. Special Representative for North Korea Stephen Biegun and his North Korean counterpart Kim Hyuk-chul. And the key part of their negotiations is how far the North will commit to dismantling its nuclear weapons and missile programs and what security guarantees the U.S. will offer in return. Among the most talked about items are the closure of North Korea's main nuclear facility in Yongbyon and U.S. acceptance of partial sanctions relief for the North, as well as a declaration to formally end the Korean War. The official made clear that the U.S. will eventually need a full inventory of North Korea's nuclear arsenal, probably well before the end of the denuclearization process. But for now, he said the immediate priority is to freeze all of North Korea's weapons programs. President Trump has recently emphasized that he is in no rush to denuclearize North Korea as long as the regime refrains from testing its nuclear weapons. But the U.S. official said not in a hurry doesn't mean not important, adding that it just means North Korea will have to make the right choice. Plus, U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has once again emphasized in a recent interview with NBC that complete denuclearization remains the goal and that there's no compromise in this matter. But he refused to say what the U.S. might offer as concessions to the North. Next week's summit will be similar in format to the first Trump-Kim summit in Singapore last June, with a one-on-one meeting between the leaders, followed by a meal and expanded meetings with their respective delegations. And amid rising speculations on how the North Korean leader will travel to Hanoi for the summit, a Chinese hotel near the border with North Korea has apparently stopped taking reservations for this weekend, which might be a sign that Kim Jong-un could travel to Vietnam by train. The hotel has not received bookings in the past when the North Korean leader was traveling to China by train. For now, what he will use to get to Vietnam will likely remain a mystery until his arrival there next week. And another speculation that's been on the rise is that Kim Jong-un will use the occasion for a state visit to Vietnam. Regarding this matter, an informed source in Seoul said that Chairman Kim is expected to focus on his summit with President Trump during his stay in Vietnam instead of engaging in, quote, complicated schedules. But the source did suggest that Kim may be pushing for a working visit there with a few public activities planned. His itinerary is almost certain to include a meeting with the Vietnamese president, and there's also been speculation that Chairman Kim may visit the Samsung factory in Bac Ninh province in what could be a move to show his willingness to seek economic reform and openness for North Korea. The exact details of Kim's agenda in Vietnam, as well as the venue of his second meeting with President Trump, are yet to be released. And that's all for today's news. For more detailed stories, please head over to our official Yonhap News website, linked down below. As always, don't forget to subscribe to Korea Now for more daily updates.